Okay, so we had a request line that looks something like this. It is followed by a number of headers. Headers have this format: name, colon, space, value. Let's add some headers. When you make a request, all of this is sent at once. The request line followed by number of headers. These aren't the only headers that are sent, but these are some of the more popular ones. The first one is called host, and this is from the URL. This is the host part of the URL. It's required in HTTP 1.1. It's not strictly required in 1.0. But why is this useful? We're already connecting to the machine, so why do we need to say what the host is again? It would be like if you came up to me and said, "Steve, what is your name?" Obviously, you already know my name, so why are you asking? Well, it's because web servers may have multiple names. One web server can host the website for many websites. For example, with Udacity.com, which is hosted on Google's App Engine, each of those machines hosts many websites. So we need to say which website we're requesting the document for. The next header, this one is called user agent. This describes basically who is making the request. This is generally your browser. Your browser will put its name in there, and there's also some version info and things like that. And this is really helpful for the server, so they know what type of machine is making the request.